When Redis announced that it would change its license and no longer be open source, people quickly started to look for alternatives. After all, Redis is one of the most admired databases in the world and used in many web applications to improve performance. With Redis being open source up to version 7.2.4, basically everyone was expecting forks to appear soon after the announcement. Interestingly enough, the announcement happened during a conference called KubeCon, which happened between the 19th and 22nd of March in Paris. The conference is organized by a part of the Linux Foundation and focuses on Kubernetes and cloud-native technologies. And when you look at the sponsor list for this event, you know it is stacked. Basically, every company that does cloud infrastructure in any way, shape or form is on there. So it doesn't really come as a surprise that when the news about the Redis license change dropped, it was a huge topic on the conference. After the first shock died down, the Linux Foundation quickly volunteered to provide a new home for a potential fork that keeps the original open source license. Jim Zemlin, who is the executive director of the Linux Foundation, talked with a lot of people to figure out a potential future of Redis. One of those people is David Nally, who has the beautiful title of Director of Open Source Strategy at AWS. And he will also be the one who will later introduce his colleague Madeline Olsen to the Linux Foundation. Before the license change happened, Madeline Olsen was working on Redis as one of 5 core maintainers. 3 of those maintainers were paid by Redis the company to work on Redis. One of them from Alibaba and Madeline Olsen from AWS. But after the license change, Madeline Olsen was no longer part of the Redis maintainer team. She said that she talked with a lot of other contributors and they all agreed that they will no longer contribute under the new license. After that, she quickly made a fork on her own GitHub account and called it Placeholder KV. But the name will not stick around for long. After internal discussions with the other contributors, they decided to call it Valky. Up to this point, it was just a passion project, but at this point, David Nally will introduce Olsen and all the maintainers that gathered around her to the Linux Foundation. When they met to talk about the future of the project, they decided that their goals align well enough to work together. And with the Linux Foundation working together with Valky, more companies gathered behind the project to support it financially. The first company to support Valky financially is obviously AWS, who will likely just pay Olsen to work on Valky from now on, like they did before for working on Redis. But AWS is not the only company supporting Valky. Google, Oracle, Ericsson and Snap also announced that they will back the new Redis fork. You might or might not have noticed that one of the 3 big cloud providers is missing. Microsoft is not backing Valky, and there's a good reason why. We don't really know if Microsoft just got extremely lucky or if they knew something beforehand, but only 2 days before the Redis license change, Microsoft announced their own open source Redis alternative, called Garnet. According to their own claims, Garnet is compatible with existing Redis clients. And according to their own benchmarks, it performs faster or comparable to existing alternatives. Which should be taken with a grain of salt, as those benchmarks can perform very differently on different setups and with different configuration options, as we will see later. Garnet is licensed under the MIT license, which is a permissive open source license that basically lets you do whatever you want. While it is quite interesting to see Microsoft not supporting Valky, one company that is on the support list might surprise you. Snap, the company behind Snapchat, actually has a fork of Redis already. The fork is called KeyDB and was originally a Y Combinator-backed startup that was acquired by Snap in 2022. Their main focus is to improve multi-threading performance, which should allow for better vertical scaling of the service. Vertical scaling basically means that in order to improve the performance of your service, you scale up your existing server, instead of adding new nodes to your service like you would with horizontal scaling. With Snap's backing of Valky, the future of KeyDB is pretty uncertain though, and it makes it really hard to recommend KeyDB at this point. As critical Snapchat infrastructure is relying on KeyDB right now, it is likely that they will continue the development in the near future. But in the long term, I don't really see them supporting 2 competing projects, and they will likely just push the performance improvements to Valky and migrate their own infrastructure as well. But Valky wasn't the only fork as a direct result of the license change. Another open source fork was initiated by Andrew Kelly, who is known for creating the programming language Zig. Redict is an independent copyleft fork of Redis. As of today, it is still in a very early stage, and like Valky, it doesn't have a stable release yet. So it is quite hard to predict the future of this project, but it's definitely worth keeping an eye on. In 2024, obviously no list of alternatives is complete without one written in Rust, which has two advantages. First, it is really fast, and second, you can tell everyone that it is written in Rust. If you're looking for a really fast database, you might want to take a look at SkyTable. But keep in mind that it is not a drop-in replacement for Redis. In fact, it doesn't claim to be Redis compatible at all. SkyTable actually uses their own query language called BuQL that is based on SQL, and it is more intended as a full-blown database rather than a key-value store. The last drop-in replacement that was relevant enough to get its own spot in this video is DragonflyDB. The project does have a little bit of a different licensing model though. Right now, the license is similar to what Redis has changed to, but in 5 years, the code will be available under the Apache open source license. So it isn't open source now, but it will be open source in the future. And similar to KeyDB, they focus on vertical scaling and multi-threading performance. On their website, they actually claim 25 times better performance than Redis, but that's only one side of the story. Redis actually responded to the performance claims with their own blog post. In this blog post, they actually compare Redis cluster with DragonflyDB, and surprise surprise, Redis comes out on top. No matter which ones of the alternatives you prefer, it is definitely an interesting time for open source in-memory databases. After all, only time will tell which implementations will gain enough traction and even become the new Redis. But for now, Valky looks like the best bet for the near future. With the backing of major cloud providers who rely on Redis for their services, the fork is probably the safest bet as of today, and we can expect to have a tagged release of Valky pretty soon, which will likely be the upgrade path for a lot of people. If you're interested in finding out more about the history of Redis and how the license change came to be in the first place, check out my video The Downfall of Redis. All sources for this video are linked in the description down below. See you in the next video that will hopefully not be about Redis.